Hello, David Snopek here from Snopek Games, and this is my third progress report about adding WebXR support to the Godot game engine. So the most visible change from last week is now there's positional tracking of the controllers. So in my demo project, when I move my controllers around, you can see the cubes that are standing in for my hands moving around as well. The other user visible change, or really developer visible, is there's now some API for the WebXR interface class that I'm adding to the Godot game engine. So you can see here in my demo project, there are some signals that we can connect to that tell you different things about the session. So session supported, this is like a callback that comes from calling this is session supported method. So I can say is session supported immersive VR, and it will call back to this method and tell me whether it's supported or not. And also when the session successfully started, when it ended, if it failed, and a little message about how it failed. And then also these parameters for how to start the session. So we can put the session mode. In this case, I'm choosing immersive VR. You could also theoretically choose immersive AR, but I haven't implemented any of the AR stuff in WebXR yet. And then a list of required features and optional features for that session, which is required if you want to use local floor or bounded floor. And then this list of requested reference space types. And what it'll do is it'll first try bounded floor, and if that fails, then it'll try local floor, and if that fails, then ultimately local. So this way you could support devices that have room scale bounded floor down to less capable devices. And yeah, that's the API that's there now. I also made a whole bunch of internal changes that you can't really see here. I got some really great advice from Fales, who is one of the core Godot contributors, who's responsible for the HTML5 export and the network stuff and some other things. Anyway, he gave me some really great advice about how I could change the way the internals work. The biggest change is switching away from using all of those M, ASM, and Scripton things where you put like inline JavaScript into your C++ to making a M Scripton library, which is a huge change, basically kind of like rewriting and rearranging everything that was already there. But you know, from a developer perspective, from someone who wants to use this, yeah, you wouldn't notice any difference. What I'm going to be working on for the next week is getting the controller inputs, so the buttons and joystick on the controller, getting that passed to Godot as well. And it should be easy, theoretically, but it totally isn't. And that's because in Godot, in the AR/VR subsystem in Godot, you should be able to just do this tracker set joy ID and tell the Godot AR/VR subsystem that this AR/VR controller is actually represented by this system gamepad and its ID. And then the AR/VR subsystem will say, okay, so that gamepad is connected to this AR/VR controller. I'll look at its inputs and pass them to where they need to go just automatically. However, in Godot, the gamepads, like when Godot wants to go look up what are the operating system gamepads, it uses this navigator get gamepads to get a list of them and then registers them all in Godot. However, the WebXR spec, of which this is part that I'm showing right here in my web browser, actually says that gamepads that represent you know, WebXR controllers must not be registered in the navigator get gamepads. Look at this. Must not be included in the array returned by navigator get gamepads. So like if they were registered there, all I would have to do is grab the gamepads index and then pass it to this tracker set joy ID. But it mandates that the gamepads indexes must always be -1, which is invalid, and that they aren't returned by this function here. So they'll never be registered anyway, which means that I'm going to have to put some custom code into my WebXR interface to look at the gamepad inputs itself and then send those off to Godot, sort of duplicating the work that the AR/VR subsystem is already supposed to be doing automatically, which sucks. But it is what it is, and that's what I'll be working on over the next week, and I'll let you know how it goes. Thanks. Talk to you later.